this is the second time I've come here to Patmos for GoodWorld Journeys to teach, and both times have been kind of mind-blowingly extraordinary experiences. This kind of fairy dust magic thing happens. I think it really comes from Dan and Jenny, from the top down, the idea that we really are here to be part of a conversation that's 5,000 years old and started right here in Greece. The first recorded stories come from this landscape.
Well, this is my first time in Greece, so I didn't know what to expect. And one of the surprising benefits of Patmos and Greece in general is that there's something about this place that it sounds a little corny, but it's spiritual. There's something profound about it and ancient. And you feel that sort of seeping into your attitude towards your teaching, especially towards your students. You feel yourself part of a very long dialogue that's been going on. And from the teaching perspective, what was wonderful was they were very generous both with each other and with us.
It was about as much fun as you could have teaching.
Yeah, it was. I found it mutually reinforcing. Like, I would hear things that I had thought before but not been able to articulate that Mary would say, and then you could come forward and build on that. So it ended up, for me, it felt like a lot more risk-taking than usual teaching. If you're by yourself, you control the agenda. But with a great artist and teacher like Mary there, you have to continually up your game. And I think the students benefited from that.
Today, I taught 10th of December, and to be able to teach the story and have George there and ask him about his decision-making process and his revision process and see how that work of art comes together.
Well, teaching with Mary Karr is it's an education for the co-teacher. She's so open and frank and funny and has so much knowledge. So for me, part of the fun was to watch her teach, pick up tips there, see the way that she interacted with the students and the way she shared with them. We've been teaching at Syracuse together for over 20 years, but never it's so closely together.
I just also think George and I have had for 20 years as friends, because we have taught together, a great conversation about teaching and about literature and about our students. So we're already part of a community.
Being here, I realized I'd kind of flattened myself out with all the a certain kind of performance and a certain kind of public thing. And in this time here, I felt myself getting three-dimensional again. And of course, the physical setting, you can't, in this place, forget that you have a body, you know, and that you have an aesthetic sense. And so it was really rich.
This island, way off the charts, yeah. I think, in terms of hospitality and food and
naturalness, I think.
Yeah, they're just very warm.
You come in at night and you think, well, I hope this place is okay. And then you open your window of the hotel and it's this. And it's also this over there. And it's also this over there. And so we walked out this morning kind of just in this happy days, like, okay, this will be okay. It's going to be good.
We can suffer through this.
But then I think on top of that, you know, a lot of times I think if people are interested in combining travel with writing, they will go to a beautiful...
Or travel and read it.
Travel and reading, right. They go to a beautiful place, have that experience, and their travel or the writing and reading is a nice sort of add-on. Or vice versa, you go to an intense educational experience with maybe something to do in the evening. This was sort of an 11 in both ways, I think. It was absolutely the most relaxing, beautiful vacation and really intellectually stimulating. So you're making something that's both, you know, riotous and joyful during the time you're here, but it's also kind of a sort of an artistic investment in a sort of mobile, fluid, but reliable artistic community for the years to come.